That's where my healing came. That's where the transformation takes place. But you really need to realize that I don't care what your spouse is doing, you are in complete control of your reactions. And if you're not in complete control of your reactions, you need to submit them over to Christ and let Him help you with those things.
So what we're talking about is personality-based communication, all right? So oftentimes when you're dealing with communication, oftentimes you think the fundamentals. And we can talk about the fundamentals. And what I want you to do is write this down. What's that marker at?
Okay. That one's right.
When you're thinking about communication, there's three components, all right? First, you have your words, right? Second, your tone. And there you go. Third, body language. And within body language, you can also put facial expressions, all right? So you're dealing with word, tone, and body language. Now, it has been broken down and suggested that words are only 7% of your communication. Tone is 23% of your communication. And body language is 70% of your communication. So, words, what you say. Tone, how you say what you say. And body language and facial expressions, what you bring to the conversation based upon those non-verbal communications. You know how you can communicate without even opening up your mouth? All you need to do is look a certain way. All you need to do is hold your posture in a particular way. And your body communicates the truth more than the words that come out of your mouth. And oftentimes, our spouses aren't listening to what we say, but how we say what we say, and the position in which we come with it. And so oftentimes, I remember I would talk to Danielle about certain things, but bringing in sarcasm, bringing in a tone, she wouldn't hear my heart. Now, my heart was pure, but my package, my delivery was not. And so oftentimes, the things that I was communicating weren't received by her, and it caused all types of problems. Personality-based communication. So if I am drenched with sarcasm, if she is drenched with sensitivity, when we come together, we communicate through these filters, right? Anybody ever been in a relationship full of issues? Talk to me, somebody.
Yes.
Think about the word issues. It's you. You're the one with the issues. And you brought these issues into your relationship, and they kind of affect how in which you communicate. So at the end of the day, when you're dealing with relationship mathematics, and I remember we talked about this in February at the Valentine's Day thing, the lowest common denominator in every relationship that you enter into is you. Why? Because you take you everywhere you go. So if you go from one bad relationship to another bad relationship to that third bad relationship, what we wind up doing is pointing the finger at everyone else, not realizing that when you point the finger, there are always three fingers pointing right back at you. So in essence, you have to look at yourself three times as hard as you do the other person. You have to look at the plank in your own eye rather than the speck within someone else's. And I remember telling a story. It reminds me of the grandfather who had grandchildren. In every summer vacation, the grandchildren would come over, you know, before going back to school. And the grandchildren were always known for playing practical jokes. And so one day while grandpa...